Hello students, in my last presentation I explained to you the major events that happens in the first act of the play The Dread Departure. I also introduced to you major characters that appear in the first act of the play. Today we are going to see the major events in the second act of the play. I already told you the playwright and the translator of the play and their information. I introduced to you in my earlier video the major characters, and I remember I told you the character third from left appears only in the second act. So let's see what happens and how the story of Bahu Rao continues in the second act. You see here in this picture I have shown you the four figures. This is the picture of Nana, and this is also picture of Nana. Here Nana is telling his mother that stop wailing, make rice balls for offering. So the act begins with Nana now taking over as the narrator. You see here Nana is narrator here. Hereafter Nana is going to tell us what happens in the play. So this is the 10th day after the death of Bahu Rao, and you know that it is our ritual to take the rice balls as offering to the dead. We should go to the crematorium and offer those rice balls to the dead. You see, this is the picture of home. I have also shown you how the Bahu Rao body is kept on the storage platform. So this is Rama, and Nana tells her that stop wailing, make rice balls for offering. So he orders his mother to cook rice balls, as that was the 10th day after his father's death, and he wants to take rice balls to the new crematorium to offer rice balls. So we call it pinned in Marathi, to the crows. When Nana, see this is Nana, reaches the new crematorium, he meets two men fighting for the place to keep rice balls. They are also there to offer rice balls to the dead soul. So these two men are fighting with each other who should put the rice ball first. So you see their dialogues, "You doggy, you scrounder." Nana asks them, "Why you fight?" So, in the third scene, you see here that Nana helps and tries to sort out their problem by becoming crow himself. So here see you Nana. So he puts on the garb of a crow and comes before him and solves their problem. Meanwhile, Bhaurao also reaches the new crematorium, and Nana is surprised to see him there. Nana offers rice balls to his hungry father, who has not yet cremated. So therefore Nana says that, "How come here?" Bhaurao says that, "You don't need to wait for crow. I will eat offerings." And Bhaurao complains of his suffocation in the attic of his home, where his body is kept and where the Nana has hidden him. They talk on his suffocation. Nana tells him that, "You stink terribly." Bhaurao requests Nana to let him meet Rama. He says he wants to talk to her, at least he has been missing her. Nana allows him to meet his mother. Bhaurao wants to talk to Rama and he wants to appear before her so that he can express himself. When Rama was sleeping, she sees a kind of dream, and in her trance she tells Bhaurao that she liked the man who was wearing a black suit at the time of his funeral procession, and that man was the third from the left, whom I told you that is introduced in the second act. And when they lift the bier of Bhaurao, so Bhaurao thinks that Rama is appreciating, she is in love with some other man immediately after his death, and he feels it is very awful. So he says that, "How awful, she is lost in her newfound love." So when Bhaurao comes before her, she thinks that it is not the Bhaurao but the man who was wearing a black suit at the time of funeral. Bhaurao is surprised to see that she loves somebody else, and he feels like Hamlet. Nana feels like Hamlet because, as in the story of Hamlet, immediately after the death of Hamlet's father, his mother married to the uncle. So Bhaurao tells Nana about the man. Nana is also surprised to see this sudden twist in the story and decides to investigate his mother. Nana asks his mother to reveal all the details. Rama confesses her feeling towards the new man but tells Nana that she can't describe the man exactly. But she remembers his attire at the funeral. She instructs him not to forget to invite him on the 12th day of collective meal. So here you see the dialogue. The Nana is asking. He tries to get the information about that man secretly, covertly. How he looks, do you remember? He asks his mother. Oh, not exactly, but he had worn a suit black goggle. So you see here. So still, you see here, the soul on the dead body of the Bhaurav is in the attic of the room. You see here. So on the 12th day, Nana and Bhaurav get on a mission of finding out the man. So they decide to find out everything about him. Who is he? Was he there in Rama's life before Bhaurav's death? Or did they meet after his death? Where and how did they meet, etc. So he goes on asking all the people. So are we invited for meal or questioning? This answer is raised by one of the neighbors, because Nana is making inquiry about the third man. He says that, has anyone seen third from the left? So one of the neighbors says that, are we invited for meal or questioning? Somebody asks him why he is asking for. So that day also passes. Nana tells his mother that he is willing to help for her for the second marriage with man of her desire, and he has invited the same man to their house. So Nana and Bhaurav make a plan. Nana tells Bhaurav to wear the same type of clothes as put up by the person third from the left. So Bhaurav dressed up like man so that she can tell the truth, appears and interacts with Rama. She blushes, she is thrilled, she is very excited for beginning of her new life. So she says that, you see the dialogue, is she this reality? And Bhaurav poses that, the third from the left, and says, oh dear. So you see here a kind of romantic scene here. Now after this experience, Nana is absolutely perplexed, confused, and he tries to find out another way to fulfill Bhaurav's desire. And what is that desire? To get burned at the old crematorium. Nana and Bhaurav talks. Bhaurav tells him that, I can't bear this all, arrange my burning early as possible. So therefore it becomes for hard and difficult for Nana to find out the another way. So he, one way he finds out, that he gives rupees 2,000 to the watchman at the gate of old crematorium, so they can burn his body secretly. Nana could not understand the complexities of life. When he receives money of Bhaurav's insurance, he bribes the watchman to burn Bhaurav's body at the old crematorium. And thus, Bhaurav peacefully cremated in the old crematorium. After going through the major events, we can find out central ideas and themes in this play. So death is the central at this play, and you see the shams, the pretendants that we see of the people. The neighbors do not wait to complete the rites of the Bhaurav. When he was taken to the old crematorium, they left Nana all alone. We also see that the Hippocratic useless religious rites are presented in this play. And we also see that the effects of the death on Bhaurav's family, that his family begins to disintegrate. Thank you.